Here's a story about how me and Andrew, before we were hated friends.
Alright. One time, me and Andrew, we were like good friends at the time. And he brought his Xbox games over. Because, you know, I recently just got an Xbox. This was back in middle school when Xbox was the thing.
Yeah, it was the biggest thing ever.
Yeah. And,
a really cool game.
He brought, it was like Torark.
Torark Evolution. Godzilla. Celebrity Deathmatch.
And some other game.
Yeah. I think I might have been Looney Tunes Back in Action.
Probably. And, well, the next day,
I forgot him at his house.
He forgot him at my house. Next day, we were all sitting around the table, and we were just, you know, acting, goofing around, and all that. And Andrew was getting at his, he was just talking, and then
I was
kidding around, and I was like, hey, you know what, I'm just going to keep your games. And he was like, no, you're not. And I'm like, yeah, I am.
He's like, my mom will kill me. You're not going to keep those.
And then, so, he walks off.
No, I didn't.
Well, you went off to go tell Mr. Witt.
No, I didn't.
Well, how did Mr.
Witt... You did something, man.
What'd I forget?
I was like, can I have my games back? And you said, no, I'm going to keep them. And I said, well, I'm going to get in trouble. And you said, well, why don't you go tell the principal? So I went and told the principal.
He told Mr. Witt, and she came and got me.
No, I told the principal.
Well, yeah, then Mr. Witt.
I went to the principal's office and talked to the actual principal, and then they sent Mr. Witt to get you.
And you can imagine seeing the big Godzilla coming after me. You're fee, fi, fo, fum. I'm going to take you to the principal's office.
I'm a lesbian with short hair.
So, I went to the principal's office, and the principal's just like, so I hear you, you're going to keep the games from
you
this guy.
No, I'm
good.
And, I'm just like, I was just kidding around. And he's like, well, I'm going to need you to call your mom and get the games here now. I'm just like, okay. So I call my mom, she brings the games in, and I'm just... apparently I was going to get suspended if I didn't bring them.
Yeah.
So I brought them, I gave them to Andrew, and then after that we were
like enemies.
We were like enemies
time,
for about...
Like all you did was like, tell me how stupid I was and stuff, and I was like, well, I got my games back, you know.
And then it wasn't until about 10th grade where we really got back together, and it was the weirdest way. I was talking about Harvest Moon. You know, like, you play that game? I'm
yes,
like,
that's when we found out, because Harvest Moon brought us together. Like,
oh my god, dude, Harvest Moon was the game that reunited the friendship.
Yeah.
Wow.
That game changed my life, man.
That game was so much fun, and it still is today. You know, the next one that's coming out, you can customize, the whole plan is you have to bring everybody back to the farmland, so you get to customize the town, you get to customize your character, you get to change the hair, the eyes, everything. Customize your farm.
What system?
3DS.
I might end up keeping it. I don't know.
You can get a, you can order it right from, what is it, Natsumi's, the website. You can get, like, a huge plush cow.
Really?
Yep. It's like, I think it's $50.
How big?
I think it's a pretty decent size.
I'm gonna look at it.
But
you should play Harvest Moon, yo.
Harvest Moon is the shit, yo.
Yeah, dude. I'll see what I can get you. You have a Game Boy, right?
Yeah.
I'll find you a
you
Friends of Mineral
Town. Yeah, Friends of Mineral Town.
Or more Friends of Mineral Town.
I'll
find you one of those, and you should check it out, dude. You're going to fall in love.
For everybody here who hasn't played Harvest Moon, get your asses out of your chair, or out in front of the computer, and go freaking get it. You may go, ha ha, it's a farming game. Don't care. Play it, and you'll love it. I guarantee you it.
I've never met anybody who doesn't love it. Anybody's played it anywhere.
Yeah.